Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. I'm Christine Corrado. With me right now is Charles Theur, CEO at TRACON Pharmaceuticals. Charles, it's great to see you again. How are you?
You as well, Christine. Good morning.
Good morning, Charles. An important step in bringing your drug to treat sarcoma to the market. What's the latest here?
Yeah, yesterday, Christine, we filed the protocol called the ENVASARC protocol, which is a proposed pivotal study. Proposed pivotal study means it's a study designed to show the drug is active in sarcoma and be the basis for approval of the drug. We filed that with the US FDA yesterday, following a very encouraging meeting we had with the FDA on May 8th, where we agreed on the major components of the pivotal ENVASARC study. Namely, we will study this drug in a sarcoma subtype called UPS and MFS. We'll be dosing envafolimab subcutaneously, which makes it potentially the first subcutaneous checkpoint inhibitor to ever be approved. And we'll be dosing it in two ways. We'll be dosing it as a single agent, but also in combination with another checkpoint inhibitor that's already approved in other indications, because there's data showing that the combination of two checkpoints can cause dramatic activity in these sarcoma subtypes. You know, when I talk about dramatic activity, I think it's important to understand what is the standard of care for patients with refractory sarcoma at the current time. Unfortunately, there's only a single approved drug for refractory UPS or MFS, those two important sarcoma subtypes. And unfortunately, the drug has a 4% response rate. So when you give this drug, 96 patients will not respond, four will. And that's an incredible unmet need population. So we know from the checkpoint inhibitor literature that if you treat with checkpoint inhibitors, even as single agents, we've seen response rates up to 23%. We know that if you treat with two checkpoint inhibitors, we've seen response rates up to 29%. So just think what that could mean to patients, taking a standard of care therapy with a 4% response rate and potentially offering them a therapy or a combination of therapies with a 30% response rate. So not surprisingly, in the ENVASARC trial, we're actually studying both single-agent envafolimab, but also envafolimab in combination with this approved checkpoint inhibitor, Yervoy, with the goal really to show single-agent enva could generate roughly a 15% response rate, and the combination of enva plus Yervoy potentially could generate a 30% response rate. And that's the trial we submitted to the FDA. That's the trial we hope to start enrolling later this year at about 25 sites in the United States. These are the top sarcoma centers in the country, and these are centers we're very experienced with, and they're centers that are very eager to do the trial. And I think the reason they're so eager to do the trial is the potential for envafolimab to really transform the care of refractory sarcoma patients.
Good to hear, Charles. And before you start that trial, what kind of prep work needs to be done to actually start dosing these patients?
No, great question. So there's a lot of work that's going in now. We've submitted the protocol to the FDA. You know, now we're in the process of submitting the protocol to the sites, including the institutional review boards, to review the consent. You know, we expect that will take about a 2 to 3 month period of time for the protocol to actually open at the sites for all the regulatory approvals to occur at the local site level. And then following that, we'll start dosing patients. One huge advantage we have is that we've worked with almost all the sites in the ENVASARC study through previous work with a separate compound in sarcoma. So we have a lot of experience working with them in terms of negotiating contracts and budgets that are necessary to start a clinical trial. And that streamlined process should allow us to start a trial far sooner than we would if we had gone to sites that we'd never worked with before.
So things should be picking up quickly then. Separate to this, you are speaking at a key opinion leader conference later today. What can investors expect from that?
Yeah, I hope investors can dial into the conference. It'll be a Zoom conference. And the real purpose is to put in perspective the potential for immunotherapy to really transform sarcoma. And that will be a talk delivered by Dr. Robert Mackey, who's a professor of medicine and chair of the sarcoma division at the University of Pennsylvania. So what Dr. Mackey will do is review really the data indicating that checkpoint inhibitors are active in sarcoma and that we should really exploit that activity to approve a drug formally in sarcoma. I'll then pick up from his talk and really give a little more detail on envafolimab and the trial, the ENVASARC trial that we just discussed, to talk about our interactions with the FDA and our timetable in terms of moving the drug forward and starting the trial.
Looking forward to watching that. Charles, thank you so much for the time today.
Thanks, Christine. Always a pleasure.